Back in 2016, Apple famously removed the headphone jack from the iPhone 7. And while customers and companies alike mocked Apple for releasing a flagship smartphone without a headphone jack, it eventually became clear within the next couple years that the iPhone 7 had set a trend that virtually every other smartphone manufacturer would follow. This is Greg with Apple Explained, and I want to thank Hover for sponsoring this video. If you want to help decide which video topics I cover, make sure you're subscribed, and these voting polls will show up right in your mobile activity feed. Now, I want to start off by sharing some background knowledge of the 3.5mm headphone jack, which is one of the most unique I/O ports to ever exist, and there are a few reasons for this. First, it was invented over 50 years ago in the 1960s, which means it came out before the VCR player, a product many of you may not even recognize since it's been obsolete for so long. But the headphone jack was able to stand the test of time and remain relevant even to this day. Which brings me to the second thing that makes the port so special. It can actually be upgraded with modern features by simply adding another ring to its sleeve. That's why older headphone jacks only have one or two rings, while today we're used to seeing three. And those extra rings added capabilities like stereo audio and audio input without the need to redesign an entirely new connector. Not to mention modern headphones are backward compatible with older products. But there's one more important quality of the headphone jack. It served as a ubiquitous industry standard for audio in and out. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, when a company makes a product, they have to decide what ports would be best to include, and different companies make different decisions. I mean, just look at all the different USB ports that exist on the market today. Companies have to decide which one is best suited for their product. That's why you tend to have different chargers for different devices. I can't charge my Nintendo Switch with my iPhone power cable, and I can't charge my MacBook Pro with my external monitor's power cable. Different products tend to require different ports. But the 3.5mm headphone jack is a rare exception, because it was basically adopted by the entire tech industry, despite there being many other options for audio as you can see here. The fact that you could buy an iPod and plug its headphones into literally any other MP3 player on the market was an incredible benefit that I think was often overlooked. So it's clear the headphone jack is an exceptional piece of technology. But in recent years, many tech companies have decided not to include it in their products anymore, and it all started with Apple. In 2016, Apple held their annual press event in the fall, and fans from all over the world were eager to see what the next generation iPhone had in store, and hopes were very high, because after the incremental iPhone 6S release the previous year, we knew the iPhone 7 was due to receive a more dramatic update. Although many were disappointed when the device was revealed, mainly because its design was virtually unchanged, but also because it was missing a headphone jack, which some users felt was a must-have feature for a smartphone. It left people wondering why Apple decided to remove such an important port from their most popular product. And what reason did Apple give? Well, Phil Schiller gave three.
Well, the reason to move on, I'm going to give you three of them, but it really comes down to one word. Courage. The courage to move on, do something new that betters all of us. And our team has tremendous courage. But second, and this is really important, our smartphones are packed with technologies and we all want more. We want bigger, brighter displays. We want larger batteries. We want faster processors. We want stereo speakers. We want haptic engines. We want all of that. And it's all fighting for space within that same enclosure. And maintaining an ancient single-purpose analog big connector doesn't make sense because that space is at a premium. And third, and I think this is most important of all, when you have a vision of how audio, the audio experience can be, you want to get there as fast as you can and make it as great as it can be.
Now, I wish Phil Schiller would have left out the statement about courage, since it just became an internet meme and overshadowed the more legitimate reasons for removing the headphone jack. Like the fact that it took up valuable space inside the phone that could be used for features like the haptic engine. Apple was also able to include a 14% larger battery, which delivered an extra 1 to 2 hours of battery life. And the iPhone 7 achieved an IP67 waterproofing certification thanks to the absence of the headphone jack. Not to mention the Lightning connector could serve as an audio port to deliver even higher quality sound than before. Lastly, the transition to wireless headphones would happen faster if all smartphones ditched the headphone jack. But there are two sides to this story, so let me explain how some users were feeling about Apple's decision. It seemed suspicious that the iPhone's headphone jack was removed at the same time the AirPods were introduced. In fact, right after Phil Schiller finished justifying ditching the headphone jack, he announced their new wireless headphones, suggesting Apple was trying to sell more AirPods by removing the iPhone's headphone jack and making it more inconvenient to use traditional wired earbuds. Because if you think about it, Apple could have waited a year or two to remove the iPhone's headphone jack and allow more time for the industry to transition to wireless, making things easier for iPhone users. But they decided against it. And when it comes to Apple's argument that the iPhone needed more room for things like its haptic engine, that may not be entirely true, because a YouTube channel called Strange Parts was actually able to put a headphone jack in an iPhone 7 himself without removing any vital components. It's actually an incredible video that I highly recommend you watch. You can find a link to it in the description. There was also speculation that Apple was trying to earn more money from royalties by licensing their Lightning connector to third-party headphone manufacturers, but I don't think that was as big of a factor as some were claiming. Now, as you can imagine, there was a significant amount of backlash from consumers and tech bloggers over the removal of the headphone jack from the iPhone 7. Some even refused to buy it for that reason alone. So how significantly were iPhone sales affected? Well, sales of the device didn't appear to be affected at all. Apple sold 38.9 million units in the first quarter of 2017, which made the iPhone 7 and 7 Plus the two best-selling smartphones in the world. And most users didn't seem to miss the headphone jack, probably because of the included adapter that allowed users to connect their favorite wired headphones anyway. Now, I should mention, this wasn't the first time Apple removed a popular component from a product. They did it with the 1998 iMac by removing the floppy drive, the 2008 MacBook by removing the FireWire port, the 2008 MacBook Air by removing the CD drive, and the 2015 MacBook by removing the USB-A ports. And every time this happened, Apple received criticism from people in the tech community. But this backlash was just the first phase of public opinion. The second phase was when users began adapting to the changes Apple made, and the third phase happened once users admitted the technology Apple left out was no longer necessary. That's why computers today don't have floppy drives, and it's very hard to find notebooks that still include CD drives. And the headphone jack is already following the same trajectory. Because even though it was only removed from the iPhone 2.5 years ago, other smartphone manufacturers have already begun to follow Apple's lead. Samsung removed the headphone jack from their Galaxy A8s and Galaxy Fold, along with the Pixel 2, Moto Z3, OnePlus 6T, Xperia XZ2, HTC U12 Plus, Huawei Mate 20 Pro, and more. So clearly, there must be some benefit to removing the headphone jack if virtually every major smartphone manufacturer has already done it. But I should mention that the headphone jack isn't only being removed from smartphones. Apple also left it out of their new iPad Pros in 2018, and some are wondering if they'll eventually remove it from their MacBook or MacBook Air notebooks. So what does the demise of the headphone jack actually mean for everyday users? Well, it means you have two options. Carry around an adapter to use wired headphones with your device, or buy wireless headphones and never worry about plugging into a headphone jack again. And if you've had any experience with high-quality wireless headphones, you probably found it difficult to go back to the wired equivalent. I remember when the AirPods were first announced, and people dismissed them as overpriced and ugly. After all, you could buy wired headphones with better sound quality for the same price. But many people underestimated the unbelievable level of convenience AirPods provided. And that's why they've become such a huge success. So I think most people would agree that the future is wireless. But some may have a problem with how we get there. As I mentioned before, there is some truth to the fact that Apple was very abrupt, forcing users into an uncomfortable position that could have been avoided if the headphone jack had been included on future iPhones for at least another few years, giving wireless technology time to become more affordable and widely adopted by users. But I think overall, users weren't bothered by Apple's approach, with some, like Jonathan Kim, even calling it a non-issue. And I think he made a pretty good point when he said, "In 2018, complaining about smartphones losing the 3.5mm headphone jack is actually advocating for more wires, which get tangled, snagged, frayed, require you to be attached to a device, and can lead to devices being damaged when they accidentally get yanked to the floor or off your head." And for audio, we simply don't need wires and the problems that go with them anymore. Now, if you guys are looking to buy a domain name for your website, I highly recommend using Hover. I used their service to buy my own appleexplained.com domain, and the purchase was as simple as buying something from Amazon. What I love about Hover is that I could purchase my domain name once my YouTube channel started to get popular, without the obligation of creating a website at the same time. That way, I could ensure no one tried taking my domain before I was ready to build a website. And when I was finally ready to create my site, I was able to connect my domain to any website builder I wanted. That's because the domain is hosted by Hover rather than the website builder itself, which gives me flexibility if I ever want to change the website building service I use. But probably my favorite thing about Hover is that they don't try to upsell you, something that's really common with similar services, and that makes the experience of buying and managing a custom domain much more pleasant. Now, Hover is offering you guys a 10% discount, so if you've been thinking about claiming your custom domain name, now is the best time to do it. Just go to hover.com/appleexplained and get 10% off your first purchase. Alright guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.